Hey guys, it's Jeff from San Diego Seed Company. I am in my office where my grow lights are. I'm actually using the grow lights as a little camera light. It works out really well. But anyway, today we're talking about peppers. Red cherry sweet, we've got YOLO, we've got cayenne, we've got bell peppers, we've got Nardello sweets, all kinds of peppers today. And for those of you who have tried to grow peppers, you know how difficult that can be. So today we're gonna give you everything that you need to know to be successful. Specifically, once you get them up, how to get them from little tiny peppers out into the garden. We have tons of videos on how to start pepper seeds with mats and moisture and the heat temperature and all that stuff.
And have it germinate evenly and quickly.
But today we're talking about how to pot them up to get them ready to thrive in the garden. So before we get into that, make sure you like this video, subscribe to the channel, hit the bell, so you guys can stay notified anytime we put out new content. Okay, so let's go outside. I've got a tray of peppers ready to pot up, and let's learn something.
Okay, so here we are outside with our beautiful tray of peppers. Let's just go over quickly the thought process of why we're gonna pot up instead of just taking this plant and putting it straight in the ground. The main reason is it's April 1st today when we're shooting, and the weather is just still kind of cold. Overnight temperatures are upper 40s, low 50s. So if we were gonna take this and put it straight into the ground, it's not gonna do very well. As we've mentioned, peppers like it hot, and trying to go from this to straight to the ground is not gonna work. Now, the other question is, why not just leave this in here for another month and then put it in the ground? I guess you could do that. I don't like doing that because I want to give it more space to grow. So if we open this sucker up, let's see what the roots look like. See, I can tell already they're starting to get root bound. So it's not terrible, but if you can see here, the roots are starting to wrap, and we don't want that. So what we're going to do is pot all these guys up, and then that's going to give them a lot more time to grow, a lot more space. So we're going from this size of a pot to something like this. So let's see what that looks like. Okay, before we do that, one thing I want you guys to notice, there's debate online and in the gardening world with peppers. Do you pinch or do you not pinch? And so what I mean by pinching is the thought is that if you pinch the very top leaves, it's gonna create a bushier plant. So you take this top middle stem, go to the very top, take the leaves off, and that's gonna force the plant to send out new shoots. So I have not pinched this, and if you can see, there's already other stems growing from each crotch, which is great. So what that tells me is you don't have to pinch. Some people do, some people don't. It's really up to you. This one is good as is. The other thing to note is these bottom leaves. You can tell that they do not look like the true leaves. These are the cotyledons. They're gonna turn yellow and they're gonna fall off. So what I'm gonna do, just go ahead and take those off. And the other thing, if you guys are familiar with tomatoes are something that you can plant really, really deeply because there's hairs on the side of the stem that are eventually gonna turn into roots. You can actually do the same thing with peppers. The roots on pepper plants don't grow quite as quickly as they do on tomatoes, but I can even see right at the base of the soil level, there's a little tiny white nub, and that's a root that's trying to grow out even above the soil level. So what I'm gonna do when I pot this up, I know this is not fun, but I'm gonna take these off at the bottom and just plant it a little deeper. In theory, with time, this part of the stem is gonna be underground, and then it's gonna send out roots, giving more root, bigger root ball, and more nutrients to your plant. Another thing to note when you pot up, some plants do not want their roots to be disturbed. Peppers are one of those. You really don't have to disturb them too much. If you think about it, as long as it's not root bound and wrapped around, we're gonna sit this in the pot. There's gonna be plenty of soil all around on each side for those roots to grow into and increase the root ball. So let's actually see what that looks like. Okay, so I am gonna take my Fox Farm soil. I know it's very expensive, but the reason that I use it is it's got all the nutrients in it that the plant is going to need. I don't really need to fertilize too much, and I actually use the same stuff when I start my seeds. A lot of you might use soilless mix, which the benefit there is you're not introducing microbes and fungus and all kinds of bad things when the plants are really small. But the downside to using soilless mix is you've got to fertilize quite a bit. With me, I fertilize very little. I do some, but you don't need to because there's already plant food in the soil. So what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna put a little bit of soil in the bottom of this guy. See how tall we're looking? And remember, I'm gonna try to get that stem right at the base, so I actually don't even need any at the bottom. I'm just gonna put my plant there, get some handful of potting soil, and as I go, I'm gonna kind of shake it down. Use my fingers to push it down a little bit, because you don't want really loose potting soil, because what will happen is as you water it and as the soil gets wet, it's just gonna sink down. So you don't wanna jam it in really hard, but you do want to give it a little firm press. So let's get this up to the top. Okay, so once you get to this point, you've got two options. You can take your watering can and water it in. What the watering in is gonna do is give the roots and the soil contact. So it's gonna push that soil in around all the roots. So that's one way, that's called top watering. The other way, then the way that I'm gonna do it is I'm gonna just put it over in this tray right here. It's already got about an inch of water and I'm just gonna leave it. And over time, that water is gonna soak up and saturate all the soil and you'll be good to go. One thing to note is that peppers are totally fine being a little dry. You can actually do a little bit of damage if you don't let them dry out, which is kind of what I've done here. If you could feel how heavy this is, there's a lot of moisture in this pot, probably too much. Now this is something that you're just gonna have to do trial and error and learn over time, but the rule of thumb is they survive well in arid climates. You can keep them a little drier. You don't need to saturate the soil quite as much as you would with tomatoes or eggplants. Let it dry out a little bit, not too dry. The plant is gonna tell you when it needs water. These leaves are gonna start drooping, then you can give it a shot of water. It's really a balancing act. We have tons of videos about watering and when to water, how much to water. This is something, as a gardener, you're just gonna learn over time. Okay, and another word from the wise, when you are potting up, the worst thing that you can possibly do is forget which peppers are which, because if you look at this tray, they all look pretty much the same. Yeah, exactly the same. This is a chile chilaca, and I know the way that I plan them for plant tags, I use one, and I put it in the left, and then I read the tray like a book. So I know if chilaca's here, everything to the right is gonna be chilaca until I get to the next one, which is a YOLO bell pepper. Then all those are YOLO. We've got red cherry sweet, we've got two Merlot bells, we've got one Nardello, two Thai, and two jalapeno. And then these eight right here are California Wonder. The trick when you pot up is doing one variety at a time. So I'm gonna do four chilaca. I'm gonna set them all in this row and then put this plant tag here, just cause I'm kinda lazy and I don't wanna get four tags, write them out. It's kinda living on the wild side because there's been several times when I put it in the ground and then it grows up and it's not what I thought it was. Who cares? You can tell what it's gonna be at the end. A chilaca is gonna look different than a Nardello, is gonna look different than a Merlot, look different than a YOLO. So if you mess them up, not the end of the world. It's kind of a surprise once the peppers start to mature and you're like, oh, that's what that is. So yeah, you can have fun with that. But if you like to label them, just get a bunch of labels and label each new pot. In terms of technique, you guys will find your own way, but one thing that I do is I'm just gonna put my finger, make sure the plant is in the very middle, put my finger on it so it stays in the middle, and then fill it up from there. The reason you wanna keep that plant in the middle is if I were to put this in one corner, then there's two sides that really have nowhere, the roots have nowhere to grow, and everything's gonna grow out. What you're trying to create is a bigger root ball, so by putting the plant in the very middle, it's giving room on all sides to grow out. So you'll notice when I pulled that one out, a little of the soil fell off the bottom, which is totally fine. You can see the roots hanging there. They look beautiful. So now what I'm gonna do is just add a little bit to the bottom of this, just so we get that height right where we want. Another pro tip when you're potting up, don't fill the soil all the way to the top of the pot. If you're bottom watering, it's fine, but at some point you might want to top water, and so you always want to leave a little bit of space for the water to actually sit before it falls down into the soil. If you go to the top and you try to water on the top, a lot of times that water is just going to roll right off. So give yourself a little space. Okay, so I got my four chilaca done. I've got 8 California Wonder to go and a bunch of other of these spicy and sweet peppers. One thing I did want to show you guys, just to be honest about peppers, it's really hard. And I'm going to be honest, where did I put those? So what you're looking at here is about 30 pepper plants. You'll notice here I've got 7 cells that didn't even come up. I've got Scotch Bonnet that didn't come up, Padron and Cayenne. I did everything that I always do, but that's another pro tip, is that start more than you think you need, especially with peppers. The worst case scenario, if you have more than you need, you can give them away. But what I've done now is lost myself almost a month and a half. I'm gonna have to restart these or not have Scotch Bonnets and Padrones and Cayennes. No problem. Losing a month and a half in zone 9 and 10 is not that big of a deal because we've got such a long growing season. But I'd show you this just to explain that peppers are tough, and sometimes they don't pop up. Okay, so one other thing that I wanted to talk about, I'm gonna take these cotyledons off because we don't need them anymore. But I want you guys to see that in the very center of that plant, there's flowers. And that is exciting because flowers become peppers. But it's not so exciting for me because this is nowhere near the size of a pepper plant that's gonna support an actual pepper. We wanna go after root growth and we wanna go after plant leaf growth. If you're getting flowers this early, it can be exciting, but it's not so great. So I'm gonna do the unthinkable, and you guys aren't gonna like this, but I'm actually gonna go in and I'm gonna take these flowers off. And the reason I'm doing that is I don't want the plant to flower yet. So I'm pinching these flowers off. Don't worry, that's not the only flowers this plant is gonna produce. But what it is doing is it's telling the plant, we don't want flowers yet, we want more leaf growth, and hopefully that will buy us some time for this plant to get bigger in its bigger home. And then by the time that we put it out in the ground, it's gonna continue to try to put out flowers, but I'm buying myself some time to get some more leaf growth before we put it into the ground. Okay, so I won't bore you with the rest of the potting up. I'm gonna do this after I'm done recording, but this begs the next question. What do I do with these? I've taken a tray, 30 plants can fit in this one tray, and I, at the end of it, I'm gonna have 3 full trays of pepper plants. Luckily for me, I've got 4 spots inside, so I'm actually going to take these back inside where it's warm. They're not gonna have to deal with the 45, 50 degree overnight temperatures. It's gonna stay 70, 75 in there the whole time until they get bigger and until the ambient temperature outside gets a little higher. These plants are gonna get bigger, more leaves, and then at that time, probably it's April 1st now, sometime in May, these are gonna be ready to go out into the ground. I'm gonna start hardening these off in the meantime. So during the day, on a mild day, not too hot, not too windy, I'll just bring these out, sit them in the sun, let the wind hit them, get them a little more stronger. And then at night, definitely gonna take them back inside. So getting pepper plants from seed, in my opinion, is one of those tricky things you have to do in the garden. Zone 9 and 10 is great, but we do have chilly nights and these peppers aren't gonna like it. Will it kill them to be overnight? Absolutely not. But what I'm trying to do is replicate its natural environment the best way I can. And I do that with a combination of being inside under grow lights, being outside, and then once the temperatures hit where I think that they're ready for it, I'll send them out into the real world. Okay, so now you know how to keep them watered, you know how to pot them up, you know how to get them out into the ground. Like I said, I'm gonna let these grow a little bit longer before I put them in the ground, but what I wanna hear from you guys is, what peppers are you growing this year? What do you do? Do you do the things that I do? Do you do different things? We're always ready to learn more, and so we wanna hear from you guys.